Good evening.
Hello, hello, welcome.
Thank you.
How are you today?
I'm great.
Excellent. I'd like to hear that.
Thank you. Teacher, I have a problem in the meeting test. In the last part is the number 3 and 4. And the answer is no me la acepta la respuesta. La he escrito de mil y una maneras y no me la acepta. Mi teléfono, por favor.
Puede suceder que como ya ingresó varias veces la respuesta, se la puede tomar mal. Ya, sí. Porque como ya la ingresó demasiadas veces, quizás tiene unas veces limitadas para ingresar. Pero sí, vamos a, voy a consultar qué pasa con el
test. Sí, es en la pregunta 2 del Miren Test, de okay. la última parte, porque ahí me he quedado, no puedo avanzar más de esa. Gracias, teacher.
Ok, con gusto, Miss.
Good evening, teacher.
Good evening, Miss Sonia. Welcome.
Thank you.
Good evening.
Good evening, Miss. Ok, vamos a tomar la asistencia de este día. Espero que hayan tenido un excelente martes. Ok, vamos a dar inicio. Mr. Alexander Aarón Toño Flores. Arely del Carmen Cortés de Peña. Miss Brenda Lizeth García Orellana.
Present.
Miss Carolina Eleonor Cardona de Alvarado.
Present, teacher.
Okay, Miss. Edgar José Cruz Amaya.
Present, teacher. Mire, solo para informarle que Ricardo Alvarenga ya va a entrar, solo está atendiendo unas cosas del trabajo.
Ok, muchas gracias. Vamos con Elvin Alexander. Elvin Alexander. Erika Beatriz Urbina Guardado. Francisco Antonio Renderos. Heidi Marisol Mengíbar Mengíbar. Kelly Marisol Escobar Hernández.
Present.
Thank you, Miss. José Nicolás García Maravilla.
Present, teacher.
Thank you, sir. Juan Ricardo, Juan Alberto Rivas.
Present, teacher.
El doctor también de Gualinda.
Juan Ricardo Menedemo Delgado Vázquez. Juan Ricardo Menedemo Vázquez. Laura Noemí Rivas Rivas. Laura Noemí Rivas Rivas. Maritza Reyes López. Ronald Alexis Gómez. Ronald Alexis Gómez. Sonia Miriam Cortés Vargas. Wilmer Fabricio.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Okay, let's start. Ok, vamos a recordar, Mr. Alexander, ¿qué vocabulario usted recuerda de la unidad 2? ¿Alguna palabra que usted recuerde? ¿Que usted aprendió en la unidad 2?
Like,
warranty.
Warranty.
Ok, good. How about Miss Sonia? Tell me the vocabulary that you learn in the unit number 2.
Could, can. Size, dimension, storage.
Storage, good, excellent. Thank you very much. Okay, let me see, Miss Jenny. Do you remember the structures, the grammar structures that we studied in the unit number 2? Las estructuras gramaticales que estudiamos.
For would.
Would, excellent.
I say the structure.
Sí, esa es una, ¿verdad? Would.
Would.
Otra que usted recuerde, aparte de would, que estudiamos.
Going to.
Going to, excellent. Be going to.
And can, could.
Ah, good. Can, could. Perfect. Thank you very much for your participation.
You're welcome.
Okay. Vamos a recordar un poco sobre can and could. Can también se puede expresar, expresa también habilidad. Y could puede expresar, lo podemos utilizar en este contexto para pedir o solicitar algo de una forma. Podemos llamarlo con buenos modales. Could es más formal que can. Por ejemplo, es como cuando usted dice, ¿podría usted? ¿Ok? ¿Podría usted? All right. For example, vamos a completar estas preguntas. Y número uno, ¿cómo completaría usted la número uno? What can you
do in your job?
I'm sorry?
Doing your job.
What can you do? What can you do in your job? Excellent. What can you do in your job? ¿Qué puedes hacer en tu trabajo? Okay, excellent. What can you do in your job? Another option for number one. Otra opción para la número uno. What can you?
What can you do to improve your English?
Excellent. What can you do to improve your English? Perfect. And in the last option for number one, la última opción para el número uno.
What can you cook for dinner tonight?
Excellent. What can you cook? What can you cook? Excellent. Very good. Okay, let's go to the option, to the question number two. Question number two begins and it says, when could you, who has the option for number two?
When could you send me the report?
Excellent. When can you send me the report? Perfect. ¿Cuándo podría enviarme el report? Muy bien. When could you? Who has different option for number two? Miss Jenny, do you have an option for number two?
When could you bake a cake?
Okay, when could you bake a cake? Perfect. Mr. Wilmer, do you have an option for number two?
When could you borrow me $10?
Okay, very good. When could you borrow me? Excellent. Vamos con la número tres. Número tres comienza con where can you? Where can you? ¿A dónde puedes tú? Where can you? Miss Sonia, do you have an option for number three?
Where can you stay for me?
Okay, where can you stay for me? Good. Excellent. Let me see. How about Miss Marisol? Number three. Miss Marisol Menjiva. Number three. Where can you? Okay, how about Miss Brenda Lizeth? Number three. Where can you?
Where can you watch the movie?
Where can you watch the movie? Excellent. Okay, number four. How could you? ¿Cómo podría usted? How could you? ¿Qué respuesta podríamos colocar en la número cuatro? O qué pregunta, perdón. How could you?
Could you help me?
I'm sorry?
How could you help me?
How could you help me? Excellent. ¿Cómo podrías ayudarme? How could you help me? How could you help me? Excellent. A different option for number four. How could you?
How could you learn? A new language.
Okay, how could you learn a new language? How could you learn a new language? Perfect. Excellent. Who said number four? También escuché a alguien más, pero no lo puedo reconocer. How could you? Okay, how about number five? Who can you? ¿Quién puede?
Who can you fix the car?
Who can you fix the car? Excellent. Who can you fix the car?
And who can you attend the client?
Excellent. Who can you attend the client? Excellent. And finally, six, why could you do? I'm sorry, why could you? Number six, why could you?
when could you
take a photo?
Why could you take a photo? Why could you take a picture? Okay, good. Excellent. Ok, ahora vamos a estudiar un poco sobre el pasado del verb to be. El pasado del verb to be. Pero vamos a recordar, antes de ir al pasado del verb to be, vamos a recordar el presente, okay, del verb to be. Y comenzamos con she is. ¿Cuál sería el siguiente? She is. Vamos con Mr. Alexander. She is. Now you tell me one. Dígame usted uno.
You are.
You are, perfect. Mr. Wilmer?
He is.
He is, perfect. He is. Miss Carolina?
Perdón.
Es fácil saber las dos formas.
Perdón, no le escuché lo que me preguntó.
Creo que tiene que silenciar un dispositivo.
Sí, ya silencié.
Y bajarle el volumen al otro.
Ajá, ya.
Estamos preguntando el pasado del verb, el presente del verb to be. Por ejemplo, tenemos she is, are. ¿Cuál usted se recuerda?
La ley establece sanciones administrativas y penales para las entidades que no se
registren. She. He are. He is.
Okay, Mr. Nicholas. He is. You said another one. Are. We are. ¿Qué tal? They.
They are.
They are. They are. Perfect.
It
How
is.
About he is? Excellent. It is. How about I?
I am.
Excellent. I am. Entonces ahora vamos a estudiar un poco el pasado del verb to be. Por ejemplo, para decir yo soy o yo estuve. Recuerde que el verb to be expresa ser o estar. Podemos decir, utilizando el verb to be, ellos estuvieron o ellos eran. También podemos decir él era o él estaba. Entonces vamos a estudiar un poco el pasado del verb to be para expresar él estaba, por ejemplo, o él era. Ok, y iniciamos. Tenemos was and were. Estas son las dos formas del pasado del verb to be. Was or were. Ok, y tenemos was, were en la forma positiva y negativa. Por ejemplo, para los sujetos, I, he, she, it, vamos a decir, I was, he was, she was, it was. ¿Ok? Y para los sujetos, we, you, and they, vamos a decir, we were, you were, they were. ¿Ok? ¿Y qué significa, teacher, was o were? Eso significa ser o estar, para decir, ellos estaban o ellos eran. ¿Cómo lo vamos a diferenciar? Pues eso va a depender del contexto, lo que dice la oración. ¿Ok? Por ejemplo, tenemos la forma, aquí dice, she was at school yesterday. She was, ella estaba en la escuela ayer. ¿Ok? También se expresa y se coloca en el pasado simple. Okay. ¿Cuándo es el pasado? Por ejemplo, ayer, dos días atrás, el año pasado, la última vacación, la última semana. Okay. Entonces nos vamos a ubicar en el pasado. Okay. Les voy a dar tiempito para que puedan, no sé si quieren, si gustan tomar un screenshot de esta información o si la van a copiar. También tenemos la forma negativa. La forma negativa es wasn't. ¿Qué wasn't? Es la contracción de was not. Y también tenemos weren't. Weren't, que es la contracción de la forma were not. Were not. Continuamos, ¿ok? Decíamos que para I sería I was. He was. She was. It was. Okay, once again. I was. I was. He was. She was. It was. Okay, y en el caso de where, lo vamos a utilizar con we were, you were, they were. Y las formas negativas son wasn't, wasn't, and weren't. ¿Puedo continuar? Ok, yes. Thank you. Ok, ¿cómo vamos a hacer la pregunta? Vamos a hacer preguntas con el verb to be en la forma pasada, colocando al inicio, ya sea was o sea were. Por ejemplo, vamos a decir, was I hungry? Was he hungry? Was she hungry? Was it hungry?
Good evening.
Good evening. Aquí estamos haciendo la forma pasada. La forma pasada. Ahora vamos con where. Vamos a colocarlo al inicio. Vamos a decir, were we, were you, were they. Tenemos la pregunta, por ejemplo, were we at the theater last week? Were you at the theater last weekend? También, como pueden darse cuenta, utiliza expresiones en el pasado. Por ejemplo, last weekend. Last weekend. El último fin de semana. También podemos decir ayer. Yesterday. Vamos a decir el último mes. Last month. Dos días atrás. 2 days ago. Son expresiones de tiempo en el pasado. Y vamos a tener, vamos a practicar un poco. Ok, vamos a ver, el número uno. I
wasn't.
I wasn't. Excellent, I wasn't. I wasn't. Vamos con el número dos.
I were.
I was or I wasn't.
Was.
I was or...
Cool.
I was at school.
Yeah. I was at school. I was at school. Number three.
Watch. I watch Happy Week Cow.
Yeah.
I was happy because my friends
were.
Yeah.
My friends were at school. Where. Ok, tenemos más ejercicio de estos. Ok, vamos a pedir, vamos a ir nombrando a los estudiantes. Ok, por ejemplo, vamos a iniciar con Miss Jenny. Number one, please. Look at the picture.
Tom was or wasn't? Was?
Yeah!
Was in the playground last week. Estaba en el área de juegos. Playground. Ahora vamos con la número dos. Vamos a pedirle a Mr. Elvin. Number two.
He was with his dad.
He was with his dad. Excellent. Vamos con el número tres. Vamos a pedirle que nos ayude a Miss Carolina. Tom's mom. Está negativa porque no estaba la mamá de Tom, solamente estaba el papá. Que mira, si fijan la imagen, solamente está el papá, entonces la mamá no estaba. Entonces vamos a colocar. Wasn't, no estaba, wasn't. Vamos con la última, he
wasn't.
Nope.
No, hey. He was
in the swing.
He was in the swing. Swing.
Okay. Vamos a pedirle a Miss Arely que nos ayude en la número 1. Sally and Tom in the zoo.
Sally and Tom were in the zoo last weekend.
Yeah.
Excellent. Sally and Tom were. Perfect. Vamos con number 2. Miss Sonia, please.
There were elephants in the zoo.
Yeah.
Excellent. There were elephants. They. Vamos con Mr. Alexander. They.
¿Qué es? Hugh. La palabra Hugh, ¿qué es?
I'm sorry?
La palabra Hugh, ¿qué es?
Who? Let me double check.
Huge.
Huge, grande.
Enorme.
¿Ellos eran o ellos no eran? Enorme.
Where?
Yeah.
Excellent. They were huge. Ellos eran enormes. They were. Okay. But the children. The children.
Where
not?
Where?
Nope.
Watch.
Weren't.
Watch.
Yeah.
Weren't.
Nah.
Weren't scared. Okay. Let's see. Mr. Nicholas, number 1. Yesterday, eat. Mr. Nicholas?
Oh, yesterday is where it is not been.
It where? Nope.
What snowy?
Yeah!
Was snowy. Good. Example number 2. Miss Erika Urbina. Eat. It was. Let's check it out. Nope. Wasn't.
Yeah.
Wasn't. Okay. No estaba caliente. Estaba nevando. Wasn't hot. But the boys, Miss Marisol. Ah, she has problem with her audio. Okay, Mr. Juan Alberto Rivas. The boys.
The boys weren't.
Excellent. No estaban tristes. Weren't sad. They?
Were.
Yeah.
They were happy. And the children?
Well.
Where?
Yeah.
Excellent. The children were in the garden. In the garden. Excellent. I was in the zoo yesterday. ¿Cómo sería la forma negativa? I was.
I was not. I don't know. I stay.
Wasn't in the zoo yesterday.
I wasn't in the zoo yesterday. Excellent. Muy bien. I wasn't in the zoo yesterday. My friend is 6 years old.
My friend, I know a year old now.
Not.
He was 5 years old last year.
Yeah.
He was five years old last year.
She,
the weather was raining yesterday. ¿Cómo estaría ahora el clima? The weather.
The weather was rain yesterday.
The weather, it is sunny today. Sunny. Sunny. He was a student 10 years ago. Él era un estudiante 10 años atrás. ¿Seguirá siendo un estudiante? Vamos a... ¿Qué sería ahora? He is... He was...
A teacher, ¿eh?
He wasn't.
He is a teacher now. He is a teacher now. I was fat when I was young. I was fat when I was young. I am slim now. I am slim now. Okay. No es más. My friend is 6 years old. He was 5 years old last year. The weather was rainy yesterday. It is sunny today. Como pueden darse cuenta, en el pasado utilizamos expresiones como yesterday, last week, 10 years ago. Y en el presente utilizamos expresiones como today, now. He was a student 10 years ago.
Tomorrow.
He is a teacher now. Tomorrow lo utilizamos en el futuro para decir mañana. Mañana. Okay, I was fat when I was young. I am slim now. Okay, very good. Muy bien. Vamos a ir a la página 30, por favor, del manual. Page 30. Page 30. Ejercicio 5. Okay, vamos a darle, vamos a tomarnos 5 minutos. 5 minutos para la realización del ejercicio 5. En la página 30, exercise 5, page 30. Dígame, mister.
Creo que no puede dejarme fuera de la sala. Es que quería preguntarle una cuestión. Fíjese que en la plataforma para hacer el meter, he venido teniendo problemas y no pongo la oración de varias formas, pero me las tira siempre erróneas. No sé en qué estaré fallando. No sé si me puede ayudar ahí.
Ok, solo que ahorita no estamos en breakout rooms. En la siguiente actividad lo dejo fuera.
Bye.
Mr. Aaron.
Hola.
Hello, teacher.
Hello, hello.
Aquí, Ricardo Alvarenga.
Okay, got it. Thank you, Mr.
Welcome.
Ok, ya haya finalizado, me escribe en el chat. Finish, please. Thank you, Miss Sonia. Okay, I have Miss Sonia, Mr. Alberto, Miss Carolina. Okay, they already finished. Okay, two students more to begin. Two students more. Los que ya finalizaron, los que ya finalizaron pueden colocar finish en el chat, por favor. En el chat de Zoom. Thank you, Mr. Wilmer. Okay, good, excellent. All right, let's start. Vamos a iniciar con el número uno.
I intercense the product.
I
intercense.
Okay, ¿cuál es el pasado del verb to be?
Was
intercense the product. Intercense.
Excellent. Okay, number two. Who has number two?
You bought the item in December.
Okay, número tres. She.
She read.
She read. Se pronuncia diferente, pero se escribe igual. She read.
Policies.
Excellent. Four.
The supervisor gave me a discount.
A discount. Five.
They sent the contract to my email.
And finally,
it was disappointing.
Was disappointed. Okay, and here we have the six sentences. Okay, in simple past tense. Okay, well, now we're going to have the exercise number two, page 29. Vamos a realizar el ejercicio dos. Okay. Listen to the teacher, read the words, repeat, write what the customer and company's representative do. Ok, el customer son, en nuestro caso, los clientes. Ok, y customer representative son las personas que atienden al cliente. Por ejemplo, cuando usted llama a la empresa, lo atiende un agente de ventas o un agente para el servicio al cliente. Entonces, ¿qué son las actividades que realizan los customers, los clientes? ¿Y cuáles son las actividades que realizan los companies representative, por ejemplo, un agente o alguien de servicio al cliente? Tenemos pick up the phone, understand, explain, complain, help, request information, get prices, provide one's information, assist, buy, call, and receive. receive. One more time. Tenemos pick up the phone, understand, explain, complain, help, request information, get prices, provide one's information, assist, buy, call, and receive. ¿Alguna duda sobre el vocabulario? ¿Alguna palabra que desconozca? Perdón.
Explain.
Explain. Explicar. Explain.
Pick up the phone. Pick up the phone.
Contestar. Contestar la llamada. Contestar el teléfono.
Complain.
Complain. Reclamar. Complain.
Provide one information.
Provide one's information. Cómo dar la información de alguien.
Get a price.
Provide one teacher.
Get prices is conseguir precios.
Provide
one's information. Dar a conocer información de alguien.
Buy.
Comprar.
Call.
Llamar.
Recibe.
Recibe. Recibir.
Recibir va. Ah, pues sí.
¿Podría repetir qué significa complain?
Complain. Discutir, reclamar. Ok, bueno, ahora lo que vamos a colocar son las palabras que corresponden a las acciones que realiza un cliente y las acciones que realiza alguien que representa a la compañía, un representante de la compañía. Okay, let me know when you finish, please. Miss Sonia finished again. Okay, thank you, miss. She's done. Mr. Wilmer, thank you. Miss Areli, thank you. Mr. Jenny, excellent. Miss Carolina, excellent. Okay, two more. Okay, good. Vamos a iniciar. Okay. How about customers? ¿Qué realizan los customers?
Buy product.
Buy, okay, buy the product. What else? Complain.
Explain.
Request information.
No. Request information.
Get prices.
Get prices.
Call.
Call, yeah. They call.
Buy.
Buy, yeah. Okay, how about company's representative? Company's representative.
Pick up the phone.
Pick up the phone.
Pick up the phone.
Explain.
Explain.
Understand.
Understand.
Help.
Help. Help.
Receive.
Receive. Yeah, receive.
That's it.
Assist. Assist.
Provides one's information.
Yeah, can be. Provides one's information. And request information as well. Okay, también piden información. Okay, good. Muy bien. Ahora vamos a practicar un poco sobre el was and where. Vamos a realizarlo. Vamos a, okay, voy a colocar un link en el chat. Este es un mini game que les va a ayudar bastante a practicar was and where, was and where. Okay, ya lo coloqué en el chat. Let me know when you finish, please. Mr. Wilmer, did you finish?
Not yet.
Not yet, okay.
Okay, I don't teach.
Excellent. Do you have a grade?
3:47.
Can you send the screen? Chat, please. Okay. Okay, good. Good time. 45 out of 45. So that means you got a 10.
Teacher, I got a question.
Tell me.
Sometimes I hear native English speaker, they say word. And sometimes the same native speaker, they say where. Yeah, that made me they made me mad in English because I don't know. I have heard that when it's in a subjunctive form, you can say where, but when it's in a normal sentence, I have heard that they say word, but I don't get it.
Where, like W-H-E-R-E?
No, the plural form of to be in the past.
That is an exception. We can use where, but it is for unreal conditions. You will notice that in perhaps in the coming modules, okay, because there are an exception where we can where we have to use where instead of was, but those are in some cases, for example, when we express hypothetical situations or unreal situations.
Yeah.
Well, those are exceptions. Okay, we have good times. Miss Carolina, 39 out of 45. Good. Mr. Elvin, 43, 42. Miss Brenda, 45. Miss Areli, excellent. Okay, same with Mr. Wilmer. We got good grades. We get excellent. Okay, let's wait a minute. Un minuto más.
Teacher, This morning, Sykes was hiring people.
And how was it?
It was at 9 a.m. in the morning. I was going to apply, but I am still not prepared for that. But maybe
I think you're ready.
In two weeks.
Why don't you apply for the academy? They have an academy.
Yeah, but it's where on site.
Sites where you can reach the level that they are asking for. For example, if you are that is okay. For example, you are 50 in your English level. So they hire you and they send you to a academy. So and there you can practice in a lot, and when you are ready, they hire you.
But the academy is on site, I think.
Yeah, sites.
Site. Yeah, that's my problem. I don't have time to go.
Yeah. Got it. Okay, I think we're ready. Okay, let's stop the game. All right, now. All right, vamos a a realizar. Vamos a practicar en esta en esta aplicación, este juego, pero en este no les puedo compartir link, así que lo que vamos a hacer es abrir nuestro buscador y vamos a colocar esta dirección, www.kahoot.it. Okay, vamos a colocar en nuestro buscador, que sea Chrome o Safari, vamos a colocar www.kahoot.it. Después de eso, vamos a colocar este pin, que es el 7984650. Después que se haya colocado el pin, le va a pedir un nombre. Entonces usted coloca el nombre o el usuario. Repito, va a colocar esta dirección en azul, sombreado, en el buscador. Después le va a pedir un pin, que es el que está en pantalla, 7984650. Y después vamos a ingresar el nombre de usuario. Vamos a intentar hacer. Thank you, Miss Arely. Mr. Elvin, thank you very much. Miss Sonia, thank you. Mr. Wilmer, thank you very much. Ms. Brenda, thank you. Mr. Ronald, thank you. Ms. Jenny.
De este juego han mandado el enlace.
No hay enlace para este juego, pero lo que les estaba diciendo es que van a colocar esta dirección que está en azul, esta, van a colocar en el buscador.
Okay. Gracias.
Ok. Y después el PIN, que es el 7984650.
Gato que lo hace.
Okay, we have 10 players. Okay, can we start now?
¿Y el pin cuál es, teacher?
El PIN es 7, este que está en la pantalla, 7984650. Okay, well, let's start. The boy's hungry.
Estamos ya, teacher.
Ya estamos ahí. Tienes que seleccionar la opción rojo o la opción azul. Okay, Miss Arely, she's on the top now. Second, Mr. Juan Ricardo. Third, Wilmer. Fourth, Miss Sonia. Fifth, Miss Jenny. I thirsty. Excellent, let's see. Miss Arely, first position, Mr. Wilmer, Miss Sonia, Mr. Ronald, and Mr. Alexander. At night, the cats were or was? The cats.
I guess didn't.
Mr. Ronald is now on the top. Mr. Alexander is second. Miss Arely is third. Pamela. Pamela was or Pamela were? Got it, good, was.
Sí, tengo problemas con el internet. Voy a dar.
Entiendo, entiendo.
Número nuevamente.
Okay, Mr. Ronald is on the top now.
Dicho, a mí en el teléfono la pantalla azul y rojo me salen la pregunta.
Sí, igual a mí solo el color me sale rojo y...
Miss Arely is now again on the top. Mr. Wilmer second, third Sonia, fourth Mr. Ricardo, fifth Mr. Ronald. My grandma. And the last one, you surprised, you were or you was? Okay, let's see the podium. Third position is for Mr. Ricardo Alvarenga. Second, Miss Sonia. And the first place is for Mr. Wilmer. Okay, he is the winner. Good job. Then we have Mr. Alexander in the fourth position, Miss Arely in the fifth. Excellent. Very good. Excelente. Muy bien. Okay. Okay, bueno, ahora vamos a ir regresar al manual, a la página 31. Página 31. And let's have this conversation. Okay, it says the conversation. Can you tell me more about your experience? It wasn't so nice because the agent didn't give me a confirmation number. He didn't even send a receipt for what I bought. Do you remember the agent's name? No, I don't. Actually, I think he didn't say his name. He wasn't kind. My apologies for that. And what about our product? Could you use it? Yes, I could. It wasn't so easy, but I called another agent again. He was so considerate. His name was Romeo, and he explained everything to me. Okay, tenemos la conversación entre Luz and Miss Eva. Lo voy a repetir nuevamente. Can you tell me more about your experience? It wasn't so nice because the agent didn't give me a confirmation number. He didn't even send a receipt for what I bought. Do you remember the agent's name? No, I don't. Actually, I think he didn't say his name. He wasn't kind. My apologies for that. And what about our product? Could you use it? Yes, I could. It wasn't so easy. But I called another agent again. He was so considerate. His name was Romeo, and he explained everything to me. Okay. All right. Acá tenemos la conversación entre Eva y Miss Luz. ¿Alguna palabra que no conozcan?
Apologies.
Apologies. Mis disculpas. My apologies for that. Mis disculpas por eso. My apologies for that.
He wasn't kind.
Kind. La palabra kind tiene dos significados. En este sentido, en este contexto, significa amable. He wasn't kind. Sí. No fue muy amable.
Disculpe por mi ignorancia. Entonces, apology es como disculparse. Y es,
mis disculpas. Apologies es disculpas. Apologize es disculparse.
Y excuse me, ¿en qué queda?
Excuse me, como lo siento, disculpa, pero aquí es,
sería como un sinónimo.
Es la palabra, un sinónimo.
Sería como sinónimo. Ah, ok.
Dins. Es que escribí como disculparse porque voy a pasar o quiero hacer algo,
Pero apologize, entiendo yo, que es como disculparme por algo que he hecho mal.
Exacto. También lo podemos tomar desde el punto de vista apologies. O si alguien lo trató mal, digamos, un mal servicio, usted le ofrece sus disculpas. Entonces dice, ah, my apologies for that. O I'm apologize for that. Me disculpo por eso.
O que le diga a usted, disculpe, profesor, le digo, excuse me.
Exacto.
Ajá. Deans, ¿qué quiere decir, Tish?
I'm sorry. ¿El qué?
Deans.
Lo siento, no sé a cuál palabra. No sé si lo puede escribir en su. No sé si lo puede escribir en el chat.
Agendix.
Didn't. Esa es la forma negativa del auxiliar don't. Eso está expresando que el verbo give, por ejemplo, está en pasado y está en negación.
Así es, correcto. Negativo.
Él no me dio un número de confirmación. The agent didn't give me a confirmation number. No me dio. Another question. Okay, well, we're gonna practice. We're gonna practice with our classmates. Vamos a practicar un poco la conversación.
didn't even send a resume for what album.
Do you remember the engine's name?
No, I don't actually. I think he didn't say his name. He was King.
My apologies for that. And what about our product? Call you, you see it?
Yes, I call. It wasn't so easy, but calling another agent again, he was so considered. His name was Romeo, and he explained everything to me.
Hoy vos sos Luz, yo soy Eva.
Can you tell me more about your experience?
It wasn't so nice because the agent didn't give me a confirmation number. He didn't even send a resume for what about.
Do you remember the agent name?
No, I don't actually. I think he didn't say his name. He wasn't King.
My apology for that. I was about our product. Call you, you say it?
Yes, I called. It wasn't so easy. But I called another agent. Again, he was so considerate. His name was Romeo, and he explained
it. Yes, I could. It wasn't so easy, but I called another agent again. He was so considerate. His name was Romeo, and he explained everything to me. Okay, cambiamos. Cool. Can you tell me more about your experience?
It wasn't so nice. Because the agent didn't give me a confirmation number. He didn't even send a receipt for what I bought.
Do you remember the agent's name?
No, I don't. Actually, I think he didn't say his name. He wasn't kind.
My apologies for that. And what about our product? Could you use it?
Yes, I could. It wasn't so easy, but I called another agent again. He was so considerate. His name was Romeo, and he explained everything to me.
Okay. Let's finish.
Excellent.
Empiezo otra vez.
Oye, le toca a usted. No va.
Can you tell me more?
A usted le toca empezar o a mí.
No, a usted quizás. Sí, a usted.
A mí, vaya.
Sí.
Can you tell me more about your experience?
It wasn't so nice because the agents didn't give me a confirmation number. He didn't even send a receipt for what I bought.
Do you remember the agent's name?
No, I don't. Actually, I think he didn't say his name. He wasn't kind.
My apologies for that. And what about our product? Could you use it?
Yes, I could. It wasn't too easy, but I called another agent again. He was so considerate. His name was Romeo, and he explained it everything. To me.
Okay.
Can you tell me more about your experience?
It wasn't so nice.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
You said call it. But I called another agent again.
Okay.
DJ Ryan. And explaining this verb in past.
Which one, sir?
The cold.
Cold.
But I called another agent. Again. I'm just trying to explain the past form of this verb.
Okay.
Okay, let's practice again.
Yeah.
Porque
si yo solo me metí.
O yo con Carolina. Carolina, no, don't turn off your microphone.
Yes.
Can you tell me more about your experience?
Ya me dio pánico escénico, Pérez. Solo it wasn't so nice because the agent didn't give me a confirmation number. He didn't even send a receipt for what I bought.
Do you remember the agent's name?
No, I don't actually. He didn't say his name. He wasn't Kane.
Kane. He wasn't Kane.
He wasn't Kane.
Yeah. My apologies for that. And what about our product? Could you use it?
Yes, I could. I wasn't so easy. But I called another agent again. He was so considerate. His name was Romeo, and he explained everything to me.
Voy a ir y busque. A ver qué le había pasado.
Good. What are we going to do now?
You finished practicing.
Okay. Yes.
Just hold on. I'm gonna see if group 7 and group 5 they read if they finished.
Okay.
Hello, teacher.
Ah, okay.
Ajá, entonces.
Okay, here we are. Okay, well, now we're gonna read the conversation. Okay, again, vamos a coger a Miss Brenda and let me see, Mr. Ronald Gomez, Miss Brenda and Mr. Ronald Gomez. Vamos a iniciar con Miss Brenda, después con, contesta Mr. Ronald. Are you ready?
Okay.
Okay, there it is. 3, 2, 1, action.
Can you tell me more about your experience?
It wasn't so nice because the agent didn't give me a confirmation number. He didn't even send a receipt for what I bought.
Do you remember the agent's name?
No, I don't actually. I think he didn't say his name. It wasn't King.
My apologies for that. And what about our product? Could you use it?
Yes, I called. It wasn't so easy, but I called another agent again. He was so considerate. His name was Romeo, and he explained everything to me.
Okay.
Excellent. All right. Okay. Para ustedes, ¿qué significa la palabra actually? Actually.
Actualmente.
Actually, hay una pequeña confusión. Y una pequeña
en realidad.
En realidad, ok. Nos confundimos un poco porque en español actually significa actualmente. Pero en inglés actually significa realmente. Ok, para que no cometamos, no quedamos en confusión. Ok, realmente, actually. Ok, now, Miss Jenny, please. And Mr. Wilmer. Miss Jenny, she begins. Mr. Wilmer, he answers.
Okay. Can you tell me more about your experience?
It wasn't so nice because the agent didn't give me a confirmation number. He didn't even send a receipt for what I bought.
Do you remember the agent's name?
No, I don't. Actually, I think he didn't say his name. He wasn't kind.
My apologies for that. And what about our product? Could you use it?
Yes, I could. It wasn't so easy, but I called another agent again. He was so considerate. His name was Romeo. And he explained everything to me. Ay, madre.
Excellent. Very good. Now, Miss Arely and Miss Sonia, please. Miss Arely begins and Miss Sonia answers.
Okay. Can you tell me more about your experience?
It wasn't so nice because the agent didn't give me a confirmation number. He didn't even send a receipt for what I bought.
Do you remember the agent's name?
No, I don't. Actually, I think he didn't say his name. He wasn't kind.
My apologies for that. And what about our product? Could you use it?
Yes, I could. It wasn't so easy, but I called another agent again. He was so considerate. His name was Romeo, and he explained everything to me.
Excellent. Very good, Romeo. Very good. Okay, now Mr. Alexander and let me see, Miss Carolina.
Okay.
So,
yes.
Can you tell me more about your experience?
It wasn't so nice because the agent didn't give me a confirmation number. He didn't even send a receipt for what I bought.
Did you remember the agent's name?
No, I don't. Actually, I think they didn't say his name. He wasn't Kane.
My apologies for that. And what about our product? Could you use it?
Yes, I called. I wasn't so easy, but I called another agent again. He was so considerate. His name was Romeo, and he explained everything to me.
Excellent. Just one recommendation, you say, well, it says you didn't say. He didn't say his name. Excellent. Good.
Okay,
well, let's continue. Vamos a continuar. Pero antes de eso vamos a tomar la asistencia. Okay, you ready? Bueno, iniciamos con Mr. Alexander.
Present.
Miss Arely del Carmen Cortés.
Present.
Thank you. Brenda Lisset García Orellana.
Present.
Carolina Eleonor Cardona de Alvarado.
Present, teacher.
Edgar José Cruz Amaya.
Present, teacher.
Elvin Alexander Alvarado Díaz.
Present, teacher.
Erika Beatriz Urbina Guardado.
Present, teacher.
Francisco Antonio Renderos. Katie Marisol Menjivar Menjivar. Jenny Marisol Escobar Hernández.
Present.
Thank you. José Nicolás.
Present, teacher.
Juan Alberto Rivas.
Present, teacher.
Juan Ricardo Alvarenga Alas.
Present, teacher.
Delgado Vázquez.
Present, teacher.
Rivas, Rivas, is Laura. Maritza Reyes López. Ronald Alexis Gómez Mendoza. Sonia Miriam.
Present.
Wilmer Fabricio.
Present. No, Alonso, instead of me.
Good. Okay, well, here we go. Okay, ahora vamos a ir al ejercicio 3 con respecto a la actividad de la número 2. Okay, vamos a colocar, vamos a leer de nuevo la conversación. Vamos a escribir las actividades que sucedieron y las que no se realizaron. Okay, cuando son afirmativos, cuando son las actividades que se realizaron, vamos a colocarlos en el lado donde dice D. Y las actividades que no se realizaron, las vamos a colocar donde dice Didn't. Ok, entonces, nuevamente, vamos a leer la conversación. Las actividades que sí se realizaron, vamos a colocarlas en el cuadro donde dice did. Y las actividades que no se realizaron, las vamos a hacer en el cuadro de didn't. Ok, vamos a trabajarlo nuevamente. Ok, there we go.
Sí. En este caso, si no me equivoco, creo que
sí
está como una experiencia, como una entrevista. ¿Va?
Vamos a ver.
Invítame a hablarme más.
About your experience. Ah, sí, ¿verdad?
Ajá, es una como entrevista. Y sí, ella como que recibía, era recepcionista.
No, dice.
No.
Que ahí le dice, usted recibió.
Uh-huh.
About es compra, ¿verdad?
Uh-huh. ¿Sí?
I was not because I had a gym. Confirmation number.
Se recibió una que yo compré. Ajá. It wasn't tonight because the agent didn't give me the confirmation number. Como que le estaba pidiendo una confirmación.
Vamos a ver, va. Dice la conversación, can you tell me more about you? ¿Me podría decir más acerca de la experiencia? Okay, la experiencia no fue muy buena porque la gente que tienen que era, dijo el tipo.
¿Perdón?
¿El director?
Es pasado. En el pasado.
De do. Didn't even say before what about. Dice, ahí le pregunta a ella, ¿verdad? Do you remember the agent name? Después el dire sería la primera en dire sería va. The agent dire give me confirmation number. Después sería la otra, he didn't even send or say for what about. Digo.
¿De qué actividades está hablando? Como que de una compra.
Es como que hizo una compra y le está preguntando cuál fue la experiencia. Es como cuando te hacen, cuando le llaman
a esa compra.
Ajá.
Ah, ya.
Ya.
Ajá, sí. Entonces digamos que la actividad que se hizo fue una compra.
Uh-huh.
Y
all right, ready? ¿Listos? Vamos. Ok, vamos. La número uno. The deed. Deed. Vamos con Mr. Ricardo Menedemo.
Yeah. Bye.
Can you tell me more about your experience?
Ok, necesito que me diga una actividad que sí se realizó en el cuadro donde dice did.
Do you remember Hagen's name?
Ok, how about Miss Jenny?
She asks about the experience.
Okay, as for experience, excellent. Let me see, Mr. Alexander.
Did.
Uh-huh, did.
She could use the product.
Okay. Excellent. How about Romeo? What did he do? Romeo.
He explained everything about the product.
Excellent. He explained everything about the product. Okay, good. And different option, Miss Brenda.
She did apologize.
Okay, she gave the apologies.
The apologies.
Excellent. Okay, what did Eva do? Okay, so Eva.
She called
the agent, and what did she buy? She bought a product. Okay, she bought a product. Estas son las opciones que yo tengo. Por ejemplo, Eva bought a product, she used the product, she called another agent, and Romeo explained everything. Okay, vamos con el cuadro donde dice didn't or didn't. Number one, any volunteer?
Didn't
information number.
Yes.
Okay, information number. Excellent. Mr. Wilmer, what do you have in the case of didn't?
Didn't send a receipt.
Okay. Didn't send a receipt. Excellent. Good. Miss Arely, what do you have in the didn't part?
He didn't say his name.
Didn't say his name. Good. Let me see, Mr. Juan Ricardo Alvarenga. Okay, Miss Sonia.
He didn't say his name.
He wasn't kind.
He wasn't kind. Good job. Okay, muy bien. Excelente. Okay, vamos al. Okay, dime un minutito. Voy, permítame. Deme un minutito.
I want to discuss.
Ahí vamos. Ok, there you go. Vamos a tener la última práctica de was and where. Was and where. Voy a copiar el link acá en el chat de Zoom. Was and where. Okay, I got six players. Six players.
Thank you, Mr.
There we go.
Tiene el micrófono apagado.
Hola.
Hello, hello.
Hello, hello.
Okay, I'm sorry. Okay, I'm gonna start taking the attendance, and today it is Jose Nicolás' turn. Vamos a la asistencia y le corresponde a Mr. Nicolás. El one-on-one. Vamos con Mr. Alexander Aaron Flores Doño. Doño Flores, sorry. Cortés de Peña.
Present.
Brenda García Orellana.
Present.
Carolina Leonor.
Present, teacher.
Edgar José.
Present, teacher.
Elvin.
Present, teacher.
Miss Erika.
Present, teacher.
Francisco Antonio Renderos. Katie Marisol Menjívar. Jenny Marisol Escobar.
Present.
José Nicolás.
Present, teacher.
Juan Alberto.
Present, teacher.
Juan Ricardo.
Present, teacher.
Juan Ricardo Menedemo.
Present, teacher.
Laura Noemí. Maritza Reyes. Ronald Alexis.
Present, teacher.
Sonia Miriam.
Present.
Wilmer Fabrish.
Present.
Okay, well, see you tomorrow. Have a good one. God bless you. Take care. Bye-bye.
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 Bendiciones a todos y todas.
Bye.
Bye.
Okay, Mr. Nicolás, como ustedes saben, tiempo de preguntas de forma individual. O si todo está claro, usted me indica.
No, fíjate que tengo algo de dudas con respecto a eso del where y del was y del where.
¿En qué sentido tiene pregunta?
Que a veces la confusión allí de cuándo hay que usar en sí el verbo, perdón, esa palabra del was y de y
ahorita
la palabra.
Le solventamos la duda. Ok. La forma afirmativa, mister. Hoy estudiamos un poco was and where, y was o where significan ser o estar, pero en el pasado. Por ejemplo, yo era o yo estaba. ¿Cuándo vamos a utilizar was y cuándo vamos a utilizar where? O sus formas negativas como wasn't o weren't, cuando utilizamos los pronombres I, he, she, it, y vamos a utilizar where con los pronombres we, you, and they.
Esos son, los pronombres, ¿verdad?
Exacto.
Pero cuando, digamos, ya no se refiere a pronombres, digamos, no, que a una cosa, digamos.
Sí, una cosa, o cosas que le dice it. It was or it wasn't.
Siempre tiene, siempre llevaría el was ahí, ajá, si fuera it was.
Sí, o por ejemplo, si dijera
pero,
Carlos.
Pero cuando
dice, un nombre.
Sería
was.
Ajá, es un nombre, pero si diría Carlos y Alberto.
Entonces sería where.
Sería where.
Porque es un sujeto compuesto.
Ajá, y cuando se refería, digamos, a flores.
Flores, plural, ¿verdad?
Ajá.
Entonces sería where.
Where.
Ajá. Uh-huh. Porque serían ellas. O ellos.
Igual cuando se refiere, digamos, a una computadora sería was.
Was, ajá.
Ya, tiene que no más expresar. Y se usa el what, las dos opciones se usan con tiempo pasado, ¿verdad? ¿Sí?
En pasado, exacto.
El was y el were pueden usarse en tiempo
pasado, sí, es que tienen que usarse en el tiempo pasado porque significa yo estaba o yo era.
Ya le capté ahí a lo que tenía esa duda, ¿verdad? Que, o sea, como a veces no refleja, digamos, el no refleja el she ni el he, no, que el nombre.
Ajá. Sí. Pero, sí, por ejemplo, si dijera Carlos, ahí vamos a utilizar
el he.
Ah, y entonces, ¿qué utilizamos con he?
Was.
Was. Ok, si dijera María y, o si dijera las, los carros, where. Exacto.
Oh, where.
Okay. Okay, le voy a dejar un, le voy a dejar un juego para que practique, ok.
Okay.
Acá está. Ahí puede practicar el uso de was and where. Existe otra pregunta. Bueno, ya le coloqué el link.
Sí, con sí, el sí.
¿Existe otra, existe otra pregunta con respecto a was and where?
No, teacher, ya solo sería la
pregunta. Ah, bueno, excelente. Excelente, Nicolás.
Igualmente.
Okay. Have a good one. Take care.
Okay.